That went a bit wrong, didn't it? This is my goodbye, Year 11. I mean, we had that thing, didn't we, at the end where everyone panicked and we said goodbye to you, but we weren't really sure. Now we are. So I came in. This is the middle of lockdown and my hair got really long, but still dressed up, familiarity and all that. It is sad, this, but I'll do my best. I mean, it won't be as good. I remember last year when Mr. Reed had all the confetti cannons and some of you helped with that and you were all saying to me, "Oh, you gonna do this for us next year, sir?" And I thought, yeah, I'll do that. But I got that wrong. Even when Mr. Cade and Mrs. Carter and Miss Bird left, they managed to get you all together and do a massive group photo, but I can't even do that. I'll do the next best thing, though.
Hey guys, do you remember the rumour where we get shoved in a locker?
Yeah!
If that happened to me, I'd be like to the Year 11s. Hey, yeah, do you want a piece of pee?
What?
Come on! Come on!
Isn't it that this floor is apparently haunted?
No.
Yeah, my brother said that he saw a face up here once.
Really?
Yeah, it was a face. And he said there were no eyes on it. Like, blank. It was really scary, apparently.
No, you've got to get it.
No, I don't want to.
I'm not getting that.
I'll get it. still stuck.
Hi, Year 11. Miss Lowing here. As you can see, I've been cutting my own fringe, which is not going well. What do I say to Year 11, my lovely Year 11s? It was, you know, a while ago now that me and Mr. Cole kind of took over your year group after all the others had left you, and we were really looking forward to it, but I didn't know you as well. And I think when I got to know you, I realised how amazing you all are and how much you have to offer. You've got so many different characters in Year 11 and, you know, every single one of you, I've got so much time for you. So I just want to say a big thank you. I know it's not ended the way that you kind of wanted it to, and all the plans we had for the end of term and the last assembly and prom and all the exams and all the... You know, in my girls group, where we planned for how we were going to go into the exams, that was a good use of time. But apart from that, you know, it doesn't end how we wanted it to, but you were still amazing. And I still enjoyed every single moment that I spent with you. You know, when I come into my office and there were eight people in there doing God knows what, I still love spending loads of time with you. So good luck for the future. This stuff will all go away and then you'll have your wonderful lives. Please keep in contact and come and see us, because we do miss you and we will still miss you. And all the best. Bye.
Hello, 11 a.m. I kind of guess this is goodbye then. I should apologise straight away for being here. My kids are downstairs, they're making loads of noise, and the only place I could find where I couldn't really hear them was my daughter's room. So yeah, this is Lyra's room, but at least I'm on my own, apart from I do have little Nell and Worry Monster, but they've both promised to be quiet, so that's good. I didn't want to say goodbye like this. I had always assumed that I'd get to say goodbye to you in person, but that's not to be. So I've written you a letter, I've given that to Mr. Cole, but you'll probably know about that by now. So I'll try and keep this brief, although I will give you what I know you really are waiting for, which is photos of you looking weird in Year 7, because that's what everyone comes to this sort of thing for. It's about looking weird in Year 7. Not that you don't look weird now, because you do. I'm saying that with love in my heart. You're a funny looking bunch. But in Year 7 you looked weirder, so you know, that's progress. I am genuinely gutted not to be able to say goodbye to you in person. And the school ended the way that it did. The day that the schools closed down, I remember you weren't even all in. Like, some of you were already self-isolating and some of you were just off. And I said to the few of you that were there that, look, if this is the end, then I've been very proud to be your tutor and I've enjoyed it and so on. But it was all just a bit rushed, and I didn't want it to be like that. I wanted to be there during your GCSEs. I wanted to be giving you spare pens and pencils and coming out and queuing up with you when you did your exams and just checking you were all right and talking to you about them afterwards and seeing you around the corridors and being like, how'd you get on? Oh, well done, you'll ace the next one as well. Like, and we've kind of had that stolen from us. And I'm sure for some of you that's a relief. But it is a rite of passage, and it's something I'm going to miss, being in it together in those last few weeks when we're doing our exams. And there's other things I'm going to miss. Like, I planned to finally get Amy and Abby's names the right way round. And I'm sure that at some point Prince was going to be on time. That would have been something to look forward to. And Maya was going to smile at me, I'd imagine. Maybe not. But it was just... And I had things to work out. I had mysteries to still solve about you guys, like Michelle. Michelle, do you play violin or piano? Because I feel like I've seen you with both, but I can't quite remember now. Do you play both? Is that even a thing? And TJ, like, TJ, what would you do? What were you doing on your phone every single day that was so important that I had to tell you repeatedly to put it away? Like, were you running a small business? You've got some sort of internet thing going on. Are you Amazon, TJ? Because I'm starting to get suspicious. And if you are, then where's my dehumidifier? And like little things that I'll miss, like whenever I did the register, I'd say, good morning. And you say, oh, morning, sir. But when I got to Jacob, I'd say, oh, morning, Jacob. And he'd just say, yes, sir. Like he was confirming that I was right and it was daytime. And I kind of found that comforting. And like, Jasmine, I mean, I'd assume you were going to get me a really awesome leaving present, like a box full of guinea pigs or something, or even a pony. You've got a pony. I was about a pony from you. Damn you, COVID. So, look, I'm genuinely honoured, and I have really enjoyed being your tutor for 5 years. And those of you who joined more recently than that, I've really enjoyed getting to know you. And I'm going to miss you. So, you know, don't be strangers. When you see me out and about in the street, stay 2 metres away, but say hello. And when this is all over, when the whole COVID thing has gone away, I mean, still stay 2 metres away from me. But do keep saying hello. And I will miss you guys. You've been a huge part of my life for the last 5 years. And I'm really proud of each and every one of you. You are fine young people. And you are going to grow up to be brilliant adults and make this world a much better place. So, good luck. Take care. And I'm really looking forward to seeing you soon in person.
Hi, Year 11. Hello, 11KH. So this is pretty weird. I haven't seen you for months and months and months. I don't know how long now. And it's still not the end of the year, the school year. Firstly, I want to say I hope you're okay. I hope you're doing well. I hope that I'm kind of worrying over nothing. I've spent quite a lot of time wondering if you're all right, thinking if you're okay. And I hope that's all in vain. I hope you're all just actually super and you're just keeping safe and you're having a bit of a laugh. I hope that is the case. So this is it. This is the goodbye. I really, really hope that I get to see most of you again. Hopefully the prom will, you know, go forward and I'll definitely be there to see you all. It's been really, really weird to not be able to say goodbye to you properly. And the whole end of the year has just been really, really weird. And in a way, I kind of feel a little bit robbed because, you know, I haven't been able to spend that last few months with the tutor group that I've had since year seven. So, yeah, I'm a little bit put out by that. But in that bit, that being said, I really, really hope you're okay. I'm really looking forward to catching up with some of you guys, or all of you guys, really. Only some of you, not all of you. Yeah, hope you're well, and I hope to see you soon. Goodbye.
Okay, so I chatted with Miss Calder for a little while trying to figure out how we were going to do this tutor group, but we decided that realistically I would probably have more to say about the group known as 11RMC. And I know that I abandoned you, but look, I'm still here right until the bitter end. Anyway, Miss Calder did want to say a few words, so I'll start with those. Short message from Miss Calder. Dear 11RMC, you've only been part of RMC for a short while, but you know what they say, save the best till last. In all seriousness, it's been a pleasure to get to know you, to see you all grow to become young adults preparing for the next stage of your life. I do hope your next chapter, whatever may come in the future, brings you enjoyment, challenges, and great memories. Finally, I'd like to wish you for every success in the future. Enjoy your life, find your passions, be kind, laugh a lot, and never regret anything that you've learned from. Also, because I'm a geography teacher, travel, go and see the world. All the best, Miss Calder. So that leaves me. What do I have to say to you? Well, RMC or BPC or even ELM, whatever we want to call you, the truth is you're not a group defined by the values of the person who ended up taking the register. You're a group of people defined by the characteristics of the individuals that make the group up. You've actually experienced a fair share of change during your time together. During the whole leavers process, I've realised just how many people have actually come and gone through the doors to your various tutor rooms. That's both staff and students. Sometimes this can harm the ethos of a group, but I actually think it made you better, made you more self-sufficient. This was demonstrated by how welcoming you were to new arrivals and how sad you were when people had to leave, with the exception of me, obviously. This ability to go with the flow perfectly demonstrates your capacity for relating to other people. And sure, you had a huge range of personalities in that group, massive, but it's that acceptance for difference which shouldn't be taken for granted. It will actually serve you really well. That's the sort of stuff which takes you through the various trials of life. As a cliche, I would actually talk now about how those particular characteristics would be what take you through your exams and onto results day and serve you really well in your future endeavours, but somewhat predictably, that went and changed as well. But it doesn't change the point that I'm making about you. You see, you always saw the change, you welcomed it, and then adapted to it, and just got on with it. And that's what you've always done. I always imagined that I would take a whole tutor group through from year 7 to year 11. And when I had the opportunity to move on, it was genuinely the thought of leaving you lot that was the most challenging decision for me to make. But in the end, I was actually quite happy to do that, to abandon you, because you had great characters, great workers and great friends. You had great leaders and you showed a lot of resolve. You were actually going to be fine without me. It would be me, in reality, that would struggle without you. And do not underestimate the importance of that community. Seeing you guys every morning, issues and all, was great. You were a family. You were my family. And say it quietly, but I'm going to miss you more than the others.
Hello. Thought I'd pop out into the front garden just to record this this video. What can I say? I am really, really fortunate that I had you guys as a tutor group, because you really made my transition to Harrow Way easy and fun, because you're all actually a really likeable, happy bunch of people. And I'm really sorry that your year 11 ended so abruptly. I am very, very, very proud of you. I think you're going to do amazing things when you go on to college. Stay in touch, stay safe. And I just want to show you one thing before we finish, which is on the first day I met you, I told you about losing all of my toenails when I walked Hadrian's Wall. But then I think I became a bit of a psychopath because I told you I'd kept them all in a little jar. There it is, still got them. Take care, stay safe, miss you. Bye bye.
Hello 11LW, welcome to your Leavers Assembly. I have written a poem for hours and I feel like I probably need to apologise in advance for the questionable rhymes you're about to hear. But, you know, it's the effort that counts, right? Let's hope so. Right, let's go for it. So, on that sunny day in September when I took on our tutor group, I wasn't quite prepared for your experience. School hadn't kept me in the loop. People with untucked shirts wandered in late through my door, mumbling about how collecting stamps was such a bore. I'll be honest and say that in that moment, I was worried about our time ahead, but I quickly grew to love your quirks and treasure our time instead. What makes a tutor group special are the individuals that make it whole. I'm going to briefly talk about everyone whilst rhyming. That's my goal. Josh BW loved to reminisce about their previous tutor's manner. He'd often repeat the phrase, C1, C2, please give me your planner. Neo's arrival time to tutor would often make us guess and talk. His humour would blame the traffic whilst we all knew he would walk. Layla once told me she wants to be a nurse. At this, I think she'd be great. She has the intellect, love and kindness to make her patients' pain abate. Victoria has an amazing swimming talent of which she should boast. When you make it to the Olympics, I'd love a ticket in the post. Molly has a wealth of talents, too many to convey, although I secretly hope she'll apply for the bake-off and win it one day. Tom will do well in life because he's smart and mostly alert. Let's hope he doesn't get a job, though, where he has to tuck in his shirt. Josh C has a passion for fitness and doing a before-school workout. He'll use this love for a career, and of this I have no doubt. Cameron will make a great chef, cooking up delicious food, from chicken to fish and beef to pork, whatever your culinary mood. Eleni's very able in photography and art. She's confident, friendly, and has a really kind heart. Alex likes a joke, but is a hard worker too. My guess is that he'll own his own company, employing the likes of me and you. Peter is funny, full of energy, and often very bold. These personality traits will guide you successfully through life, so don't let them be controlled. Skylar is known in school for being incredibly polite. This, teamed with her confidence and brains, means that her future is bright. Kira H is fab at English. Mr. Marsh tells me all the time. In fact, I should have asked her to help me with this so that it would actually rhyme. I've really enjoyed watching Finn show his acting talents on stage. It's been great to see him bring to life the characters from the page. Courtney joined us in year 10 and quickly fitted right in. Thank you for never being grumpy when being asked to remove that nose ring. Independence and confidence are two of the many traits of Anita. Welcome and warmth is felt by anyone who's lucky enough to meet her. Mikey is our quiet member who just gets on without apology. He'll do well in college and beyond following a career in technology. Christina's future is very bright with many careers she could befit. I do think comedian should be considered due to her dry and sarcastic wit. Freya has a creative spirit that she's proud to show. She'll thrive at college where her talents will just grow and grow. Jess is successful with anything she puts her mind to. By hard work and great organisation, she's a leader through and through. Harvey could be sleepy in the morning, often covering this with boredom. I'd respond to this by using the phrase, sounds like a you problem. Ollie has spent his time at Harrow Way making a great impression. His intelligence will allow him success in his future profession. Katie is strong, independent, and knows her own mind. I have a feeling she'll use these skills to better humankind. James is talented, more than he'll ever know. He's also a brilliant friend by supporting others when they're low. If you ask Kira T how she is, she'll usually answer, just peachy, unless it's a Wednesday before period one. In that case, she gets all screechy. Andre joined us in year 10 and settled in really fast. He's managed to avoid all photo opportunities but this in the 2 years past. Scott will enjoy college and be successful in whatever he does after. I hope your life is full of happiness and laughter. Ethan can easily articulate what is wrong and right. I have a feeling his career will involve defending others' plight. Hayden wants to join the army. He'll make us all very proud. We can't wait to see him on parade. I'll be saluting from the crowd. So here ends my poem, and I'd just like to say, as a group, you brought me joy, laughter, and a tiny bit of irritation every single day. For tutor group attendance, we have the winning streak. We also smashed the door competition for effort and being unique. I'm gutted that I didn't get to cheer you into your first exam or spend the tutor time beforehand watching some of you revise and cram. To share with you the absolute joy when your last exam is done, or watching your excited faces as the leavers assembly begun. But mark my words when I say that though we may be apart, 11LW, you'll always have a special place in my heart. Take care and I'll see you all soon.
Hello Year 11s. It is a very weird way of doing this now, digitally. You know that public speaking and technology are not my friends. It's something that I absolutely hate doing. And how can I put into 2 minutes everything that we experienced together? And it was a huge joy and honour for me to look after you guys through year 7 to year 10. I remember you guys all lining up in year 7, coming into the Audi, sitting in your tutor groups, being very excited, watching the faces, some of you just mesmerised of what was going to happen, some of you looking absolutely petrified of what was going to happen. But you all settled in nicely to Harrow Way life, and you settled into the family that we created in our year 7, 8, 9 and 10, and year 11. You looked after each other, you cared for each other, and now we just need to continue that through these unsettling times that we are going through. I'm not really sure what college is going to look like for you guys. I know for my police training, it's going to be done at home. And that's going to be tough for me. But for you guys, if you have to do that, then you have to do it. You know, this, your school years was probably going to be the hardest years. Now you can dress how you want. You can put your makeup on, your false eyelashes. You can have your shirt untucked and not wait for someone to say, tuck your shirt in, pull your skirt down. So that's going to be very exciting. If you're going off on an apprenticeship, I hope that it works out really, really well for you and you get everything that you want out of it. Just know that if the courses that you've chosen are not what you thought, make sure you talk to somebody. Don't just drop out of college. Don't just not do the work. Talk to somebody and everything can be fixed. You know that I'm a doer and a fixer, so there will be someone in college that will be able to get you to where you need to be. But you guys have got to ask for that help initially. We should be eating cupcakes now and saying goodbye and being very, very excited. But I hope that somehow in this weird world that we're in at the minute, that you guys get to do that. It has been so lovely to see some of you out and about and stopping, chatting and seeing what you're up to and that you're well. And you will be well. You will be able to go out and conquer the world. And I know that because you're all very, very strong and your confidence through Harrow Way just boosted completely. And I'm so, so pleased and so proud to have watched that happen. So for now, from my future to yours, I really hope that you achieve everything that you want in life. Good luck.
Hi, Year 11. I just wanted to give you a quick message to say goodbye as you leave Year 11. And so I just wrote something for you guys. So it starts, dearest babies, although I know that the majority of you are bigger than me by now, most of you were by the end of year 8, to be fair, I will always remember you as my year 7 babies. You've had such a challenging year and more changes than anyone could ever imagine. And I'm sorry that so many of you have had those important experiences denied to you. But I always said that you are the best year group. And if anyone can manage to come out of this more independent, more resilient, then it's the class of 2020. I know that you'll be going on to do wonderful things, whether that be further study, apprenticeships, or the workplace. Whatever your future holds, I hope that you can look back on your school years with the fondness that I will remember all of you with. As a group of students, you always had an amazing sense of community. And although not all of you got on or saw eye to eye, I always felt that we were able to support and encourage each other in all of our endeavours. I was so proud of you when I left in year 10, and I know that this last year, you will have continued to mature and to develop into the young adults that have so much to offer the world. You are an incredibly talented and gifted bunch, and I look forward to hearing of your future successes. Continue to look after each other, work hard, and most importantly, be kind. I hope that you all have the opportunity to be together one last time, and I hope to be able to join you. Best wishes, Mrs. Carter. And a special mention to Alf and a little picture to make you guys smile.
I do hope you and your families are all safe and well. So, you know, since I left last April, I have kept up with your progress, whether it's chatting with teachers or just more recently watching the cast. And I'm immensely proud of your achievements. And I stand by what I said when I was there, that you really are the best year group and one that I was certainly privileged to be part of, to support you with a fantastic tutor team. So you've had an unusual finish to secondary school and one which, you know, you should be proud of how you've managed it and dealt with it emotionally. While supporting each other. But now it's the time for you to spread your wings and fly. You've got some exciting times ahead and a really exciting future, whether it's, you know, going to college, doing an apprenticeship, joining the military. All right, you've got some exciting times ahead. All right. You'll have banked up many fond memories at Harrow Way. Certainly before I left, we had the sponsored walk. We had adventurous training. we had those conversations, you know, break and lunch, as I would circulate, and you knew exactly where I was and at what time, because you, some of you used to hide away from me, all right? But, you know, they're certainly the memories that I'll always revisit and have a little chuckle over. But don't be sad, though. On your way out, you're now in control of your destiny, and no one can tell you what to do, all right? You're the only one now who can be a success and, you know, path your future. So enjoy it, take risk, be safe, all right? But take care.
Looking for complication, looking through the tide of life. some things in life are bad. They can really make you mad. Other things just make you swear and curse. When you're chewing on life's gristle, don't grumble, give a whistle. And this'll help things turn out for the best. And always look on the bright side of life. Always look on the light side of life. If life seems jolly rotten, there's something you've forgotten, and that's to laugh and smile and dance and sing. When you're feeling in the dumps, don't be silly chumps, just purse your lips and whistle, that's the thing. Aim.
Always look on the bright side of life.
Come on.
Always look on the bright side of life.
For life is quite absurd, and death's the final word. You must always face the curtain with a bow. Forget about your scene, give the audience a grin. Enjoy it, it's your last chance anyhow.
So always look on the bright side of death. Just before you draw your terminal breath.
Life's a piece of shit. When you look at it, life's a laugh and death's a joke, it's true. You'll see it's all a show, keep them laughing as you go. Just remember that the last laugh is on you. And
always look on the bright side of life. Always look on.
Records available in the foyer. Someone's got to live as well, you know. All right, it's a lot. Let's get this place up there. Change his mantle within 3 weeks. What do you think plays for this rubbish? Never make the money back, you know. I told him. I said to him, Bernie, I said, they'll never make that money back.
I hope you enjoyed that. Thanks for being there for those 5 years. You did really well. We'll miss you. Not too much left for us to say, really.